Ladies, gentlemen, and you beautiful in-betweens, hello and welcome back to Signalis. I'm Calmputer, and today I will show you how to get each of the different endings in the game, but first, let's go over some of the things I missed in my playthrough. 1. When you get access to the elevator in Sierpinski, you generally go down to floor 3 and get stuck. You can also go up to floor 1 first, and get one more conversation with Issa. It doesn't seem to change the story at all, and there's only some shotgun ammo to pick up, but it's nice. 2. During the flashback sequence on board the Penrose 512, you find a small envelope, sealed and marked classified for Gestalt officer eyes only. In my playthrough, Elster heeded the warning and did not read it, but if you open it, you get a second chance to read the Elster known issues report, and the fact that it was unopened means that Ariana Young did not know that it was seen as a bad idea to befriend Elster units. 3. After rescuing Issa from the boss in the Pit of Flesh, a door 2 floors up will open. Inside you will find a small bottle and a small text log. The bottle smells strongly of ammonia. It's smelling salts, perfect for waking up unconscious people. So go back down to Issa and use the bottle on her to wake her up. When she wakes up, she says she doesn't want to use the rifle anymore, which is understandable, that recoil could definitely kill her, so she gives it to you. Now, just like with the flare gun, you won't find a lot of ammo for it, and it only chambers 2 rounds, and takes a while to reload, so not recommended if you need to kill more than 2 enemies, but boy howdy does it deliver a lot of damage. And waking up Issa does not alter any other interactions Elster has with her, though, which is sad. 3. Let's move on to how you get the secret artifact ending. You need 3 keys to unlock this ending, but first, let's talk briefly about how the community figured out how to get these keys. The radio broadcasts on certain frequencies has data in it, and if you run the audio of these frequencies through a third-party software called SSTV, you get images. Images that show Elster standing at specific spots in the game, and if you go to those spots, tune your radio to the right frequency, you'll be able to pick up the keys. Next, let's talk specifics. To get this ending, you need to complete the game and get one of the 3 normal endings first. More on those later. After you have done that, and gotten back to the main menu, press the Begin a New button to start a new game rather than load a previous save. At S23 Sierpinski, you need to go through the game normally until you get the radio. Once you have the radio, go to the isolation room, the room with 4 cages. You can kill the enemy here or not, it's up to you. Tune the radio to 96.000 and inspect the cage to the lower right. You want to be in front of it. You may have to wait for the radio signal to finish going through what sounds like test signals before you can pick up the key. Put the key in your stash, you won't be needing it for a while. For the second key, play the game normally until you gain access to level B8 on the Aeon facility. There, look for the STCR dorm. It'll be a dark room that have 4 enemies in it. 2 tall ones with shields and 2 small ones with knives. After you have dealt with them, and you probably have to deal with them to continue, follow the room up to the top right where you will find a bookcase between 2 beds. set your radio to 65.000, and interact with the bookcase to pick up the second key, the key of eternity. Put this key in your stash with the first one. For the third key, again, just play normally until you get to Rochefront and the Itto store. After you open the back door to the store, you will walk through a back room before getting to the store proper. In this room, set your radio to 240.000 and interact with the bookcase to the left of Son of the Gods. I had some trouble getting this item to pop up, but it's there. Now, be careful here, as you will not be able to return to this room once you've found Issa and left the store, so be sure to leave room in your inventory for the key. Put the key in your stash and continue the game as normal. Once you've solved the tarot puzzle and opened the hole in the wall, do not crawl through the hole just yet. Turn back, go to your stash and pick up the three keys, then go into the hole in the wall. Once you enter the small room after the tunnel, turn to your right and look down at the safe. Use the three keys to open the three locks. Now for the next bit, remember those numbers you heard back in the prologue cinematic? Punch those into the keypad to open the safe. Once you pick up the white lilies, the secret ending will trigger. You do not need to fight the boss to get it. Now for the three normal endings, Leave, Memory, and Promise. Which one you get will depend on your playstyle. I will leave a link in the description to a more detailed rundown on the specific requirements for each ending, but in short, if you are very cautious and methodical, exploring every nook and cranny, you're more likely to get Leave. If you play the game very aggressively, kill a lot of enemies, take a lot of damage, you will probably get the Promise ending. And if you keep a balance, you might get Memory. When I started my playthrough, I was thinking of doing a pacifist run, but as the game went on, I became more and more aggressive in my style, which I think is why I got the Memory ending, despite taking a very long time to complete the game. And now for each of the three ending cinematics. And there you have it. I'm not sure what I think of the endings yet, or even the story as a whole. I think I need to let it percolate in my mind for a little bit more before I come to any kind of consensus or conclusion on what I think it all means. All I know is that I love this game. It has its faults, to be sure, but then again, what game doesn't, right? I love the art design, and the music, and the world, like, just the world building on its own is off the charts. A very enjoyable and thought-provoking experience for me. But what about you, dear viewer? Have you played the game? What did you think of the story? If you haven't played the game, do you want to? And if you like to see me do more tutorial videos like this in the future, consider subscribing and liking the video. But with all of that said and done, ladies, gentlemen, and you beautiful in-betweens, I've been Calmputer, this has been Signalis, thank you for watching, and I hope you'll tune in next time.